us closer to the wind.
Never reach our shores alive.
For your sake, you better hope I don't.
Tell me when you're going to be ready to fight for real.
have to do better than that. Come a little bit closer.
You call yourself a master swordsman?
You'll have to do better than that. You bitch!
You call yourself a
You aren't worth my time.
Tell me when you're going to be ready to fight for real.
It seems the Empress overestimated your ability.
The Empress?
The island of time. The place where the sands were created. The place from which the Maharaja stole the hourglass.
And what if I could reach this island?
They say the Maharaja found portals there, where one could pass backwards through time.
Back through time. To the birthplace of the sands. Something terrible happened when our army traveled to the Maharaja's palace.
You found the sands of time.
Worse, I opened them.
Whosoever shall open the sands must die.
I was forced to kill those I fought beside. Those I had loved.
But now an unstoppable beast chases you.
For the first time in my life, I am afraid.
And you will die.
I used the sands themselves to reverse time, making it as if the hourglass was never opened.
The beast, the Dahaka, is the guardian of the timeline. You were supposed to die, so it will catch you and see to it that you meet your fate.
It is better to try than to wait here for death.
Madness. Even if you manage to reach the island, you'll still have to face the Empress of Time.
I will travel back in time and prevent the sands from ever being made. If there are no sands, the Dahaka will have no quarrel with me.
Go then, my prince. But know this. Your journey will not end well. You cannot change your fate. No man can.
Swords. Gone.
All are lost. I will find the one who did this, and she will pay.
Let's finish it.
I have more important matters to attend to.
Retreat! Regroup!
Your time would be better spent seeking sanctuary.
This cannot be.
I know you're out there. Show yourself. Where I come from, we face our opponents. And if our enemy is unarmed, we offer them a sword!
time would be better spent seeking sanctuary. Calls for you.
Looks like even I cannot escape my fate.
Escape is still an option.
All right. So I didn't have my mic on before because I had on Netflix in the background. And I was honestly too lazy to mute it. So it's still on, but I've muted it since then.
Madness. What magic is this?
She just runs up and slaps you and then runs away. So I feel like I need to apologize for the previous shitty gameplay. It's not going to get better because this game is just, it's too old.
It seems I've discovered one of the time-traveling portals the old man spoke of.
Being the precursor, or one of the precursors to Assassin's Creed, like, the same mechanics are very obviously not that polished in this game. Okay, so I don't really remember how to actually use the... Well, I'm pressing the thing, and it's not... Oh shit, I just pressed the wrong button. So that was a waste of sand. That proves my point already. I nearly raged out like hard earlier when I was playing. That part where I had to do the successive backflips, the wall kicking or whatever you want to call it, the Mario shit. I haven't actually edited that part of the video yet, but I'm going to cut it out. But there was literally like 4 or 5 minutes straight where I was trying to get onto the poles and it just wouldn't work. I haven't played this game since it was new on PlayStation and Xbox. Thank God they changed the background music. I was literally going to quit playing if it kept on playing the same shit over and over. I think this game is still worth playing now. Because it did have pretty fun and unique combat. It's just really hard to get used to. Can I jump here on this ledge? I cannot. It's been a long time. I'm talking like 18 years since this game came out. I'm pretty sure that at some point when this game was marketed, that Godsmack was in the trailers or something. So when it was new, my friends and I always used to make fun of it. I just died. I don't know what I'm doing. So, are you telling me I can't jump here? That's really stupid, if so. That's another problem, is like the right stick doesn't control the camera like you would expect it to. So here goes me dying again. Oh, cool. That actually works. And then the dude, really? This is honestly a challenge to play in 2022. Oh shit. Yeah, I mean, I think the major issue with this game is really bad camera design. Yeah, I have to use the mouse to adjust the camera. I also have no idea. Well, I fucked that up. Is this where I'm supposed to go? Just ignore the spikes for now. Is there anything here? I don't really think I have any positive memories from this game besides making fun of it. It gets a whole ass lot worse as the game goes on. I can't fucking adjust. Jesus, dude. What's over there? Is it worth dying 47 times? You know, when people talk about like old school game design, where games don't hold your hand, this is an example. There's really like no indication of what you're supposed to do a lot of the time. You just kind of have to think for yourself.
Help me with this,
bitch! Why do you hit me before I can even draw my sword? So is there actually anything up here? Where does this go? Come down here. Come on. Come on, buddy. I used to be really good at this game, but again, that was almost 20 years ago. May have even been 20 years ago. I really don't remember when this came out.
Straight to your grave.
You mother.
I can smell your fear from here.
So I'm assuming that switch probably opens this grate up here, right? Maybe a way to run faster. I guess if you roll. Oh no, you can actually run, I think. Oh no. How do I get up there? Oh, now he wants to run. Okay. Can't run up the stairs though. I see. Try this again, and hopefully I don't press the wrong button and jump to my death. You fucking stupid game. This is like literally so ridiculous that this is this hard. Like, who the fuck can't run up a fucking set of stairs? was literally there if the animations weren't so fucking janky. Welcome to early 2000s gaming, kids. Shit's fucking ridiculous. Like, you have difficulty for literally no reason. I'm telling you, this is impossible without a slow time power. Like, literally, this is impossible. I don't know why I'm still trying, because it can't be done. Is there a way to fuck with my powers or something? Nah, that would make sense. Aha! Blow me. Fuck! This is, like, honestly, looking back in retrospect, this is the kind of game in modern times where you would have to save scum to actually do anything like this. Or where you would be able to save scum, I guess. I bet you this goes in a square and it doesn't fucking go anywhere. Oh shit. Oh shit again. Okay. It would just be great if I didn't have to adjust the camera literally every fucking time. I can't see where I'm going. Just shit here. What awaits me to kill me at the end? That'd be funny if it popped up like, you can't activate this. Come back later when you're supposed to. I don't even know what the hell this is. And I just earn a sand power or something. Life upgrade. Cool. Normally I would go through and play these games with a guide open on the other screen, but I'm just not even messing with it. I don't respect this game enough to take it seriously. Okay, so that deactivates all the traps. It's cool. Hold on a second. Bro, what are you fucking... On to other things. You have no concept art. I'm kind of impressed that this Reshade preset actually makes this game look as good as it does. Because there was no Prince of Persia HD remastered trilogy on PC. We just have the original fucking releases as they came out. And we got to download mods. I wish they had ported the HD, whatever the hell. Does this go anywhere? You get up to that roof? Because I'm positive that you're supposed to be able to. I guess in a way the camera is kind of better than most of these third person games, because you can actually free control the camera in a 360 degree arc, but only like it's only working because I'm outside. There's nothing for the camera to run into. Did I ignore? What's that up there? Probably can't go in there, right? Yeah, it's not. You gotta unlock it or something. This wouldn't exist if it didn't go anywhere, right? Apparently the answer is no, it would. I actually don't know what I'm supposed to do. And I really don't want to go back down there because I'm going to die. Like, I can guarantee I'm going to die if I go back down there. How did I even get up here? My wall ran, right? Well, fuck me. Can I wall run back? The answer is going to be no, of course. Oh, wow. It actually worked. But still, like, that doesn't help me. Oh, okay. That, yeah, I remember. Please don't die. Ooh, awesome. All right, now I'm acting like someone that can actually play the game. So I came through this door. Now this is where I got confused and had no idea where to go. What about this? Obvious, nope. What the fuck? Very entertaining watching me having no idea what I'm doing. Gonna have to pull up a guide after all. So many of these columns make no sense because they're all clearly underneath something. Like, there's no way you could jump from them to another thing. Unless you can climb all the way to the top and then keep on climbing on something. Straight up, no clue what I'm doing. Oh, wait, I didn't go this way before. Just looks the same. Save point. Oh, this appears to be the right way. Damn, bro. Oh, that's because the extra life upgrade. Like, that was an absurd amount of water. That was like more than an entire bottle of water. Another cutscene, kind of. Ah, these little shit bricks. I hate these fucking guys. Come on! Don't fight me, little bitches. Oh, these guys don't actually have Yeah, they're not that bad. The ones that are bad are like the Raven guys. I need sand. I don't give a damn if I have full sand. I'm still waiting on that Sands of Time remake. I hope they can do the rest of the games. Holy shit. That's what I was looking for. Like I was trying to say earlier, the game has a surprisingly complex system of combos and shit. It just does a really bad job of teaching you like how to do them. And I'm about to fucking die here. Okay. Fuck! Thank goodness for that. Yeah, these are some classic... These are some iconic fucking platforming sections. This is what, like, every game in the past 20 years is based on, as far as platforming. Oh, fuck you, dude. This is what every platforming game needs, also, is a rewind button. When you die from stupid bullcrap that shouldn't ever have happened. Take that. Take that mace. Oh, come on. You can see in the video that I didn't touch that. I'm not rewinding to get that health back either. Yeah, I remember this room vividly. Well, mostly because there's like 36 of these rooms that are identical. And they were also in the first game. This was probably a mistake to start actually getting into this and not sucking at it. Because it's pretty late. if there was a save point here, I would save and quit. Brothers, let's fight. Oh, you can just kill me, that's fine. Jesus fuck, dude. Come on! Health I have, dude. What kind of fucking bullshit is that? Like, the block... That's one thing about this game. The block system is so terrible that there's basically no point in even trying to block anything. Because by the time you do, you're gonna die anyway. I'm gonna miss this jump for damn sure. Oh, maybe not. Okay, there is a save point. Good, I get to quit. Absolutely pick this back up probably on the weekend. I don't really like have a schedule set for when I do content, if you want to call it content, me getting ornery with games, because I don't have the time to, which the schedule might help, I don't know. I kind of just do things and then I move on to the next thing. This game is only like 7 hours long if you actually know what you're doing, I think. Anyway, I'll continue this in the future.